Hello everyone, myself Prithviraj P. Tambe, working as an assistant professor in Department of Electronics Engineering at Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Welcome to this video session on multiplexes. Let us today learn how to implement Boolean functions using multiplexes. At the end of this session, students will be able to examine the working of multiplexes and they can implement simple logic functions using multiplexes. So multiplexer is a many input device and only one output device. So the relation is defined by multiplexer having n select lines, can have 2^n data input lines, and it can be used to implement a Boolean function of n variables. So let us learn method one. A multiplexer with the help of selection inputs generate sum of min terms or product of max term expressions, and individual min term or max term can be defined by data inputs. So here you will see that you have this 4:1 multiplexer having two select lines S1 S0 and four data lines D0 D1 D2 D3 can be used to implement SOP like this: S1 bar S0 bar D0 plus S1 bar S0 D1 plus S1 S0 bar D2 plus S1 S0 D3. In POS form, S1 plus S0 plus D0 plus S1 plus S0 bar plus D1, S1 bar plus S0 plus D2, and S1 bar plus S0 bar plus S3 bar. So here max terms are used, and in the first SOP form, mean terms are used, and each term is defined by data inputs. So let us see one example. Implementation of function AB, summation of mean terms 1, 2. So SOP, so the mean terms are given and the mean terms are 1 and 2. So the logic is connect the data inputs corresponding to the mean terms to logic 1 and data inputs corresponding to the max terms to logic 0. So here D0, D3 are the max terms, so connect them to logic 0, and D1 and D2 are the data inputs corresponding to mean term, that's why connect them to VCC. So if you place the actual values of S1, S0 and D0, D1, D2, D3 in the previous expression, you will have f of SOP is equal to A bar B bar dot z0 plus a bar b dot 1 plus a b bar dot 1 plus a b dot 0. So the final expression will reduce to a bar b plus a b bar, or if you consider the max terms, the expression will become a plus b plus 0, a plus b bar plus 1, a bar plus b plus 1, a bar plus b bar plus 0, which reduces to a plus b dot a bar plus b bar. So we have SOP form as well as POS form, and each term individually defined by corresponding data inputs. So let us solve this problem quickly. Write down your answer. Implementation of f of ABC is equal to summation of 1, 2, 4, 7 mean terms. So yes, the solution is here we have 1, 2, 4 and 7 min terms, and obviously 0, 3, 5, 6 max terms. So data lines corresponding to min terms, which are D1, D2, D4, D7, should be connected to 1, and data lines corresponding to these max terms 0, 3, 5, 6 goes to logic 0 or ground. So the expression implemented here is a bar b bar c plus a bar b dot c bar plus a b bar c bar plus a b c, or you can have this POS form also. We have one more method. We can use a multiplexer having n select lines, means 2^n data lines can be used efficiently to implement a Boolean function of n plus 1 variables. So for example, a 4 variable Boolean function can be implemented using please calculate the multiplexer. Yes, the multiplexer required is 8:1 multiplexer. So if you put here the values, so 3 select lines, so 8 data lines, you can use 8:1 multiplexer to implement 4 variable function. So there are some steps you need to follow. First, tabulate a truth table for the given Boolean function. Use first n variables as a select lines. Then evaluate the output as a function of the last unused variable or variables for each combination of selection inputs. So for example, the function can be 0, 1, or the variable, or the complements of variable, or the combination of variable, etc. So you can have multiple combinations. Now apply these new values in proper order to the corresponding data inputs. So you may require some extra logic circuit. You can use if required, for example, some gates. Let us implement this previous function f of abc is equal to summation of mean terms 1 to 4, 7. So the first step is the tabulation of this table. So we have this table. So f is f column. So these are the mean terms 1, 2, 4, and 7, and the max term 0, 3, 5, and 6. Now, second step is to use AB as a select lines. So here A and B are used as a select line. So here C is still unused. So let us compute F in terms of C. So we can divide this table into four parts. In the first part, AB is 0, 0 and F is C. In the second part, AB is 0, 1 and the relation of F and C is C bar. In the third part, AB is 1, 0 and the relation is again C bar, and the last part, AB is 1, 1 and the relation is C. Now let us do the final connections. So here, this you can reduce this table with AB as the two input columns and F, and here you will see that F is represented in terms of the last unused variable. So for 0, 0, F is C, 0, 1, F is C bar, 1, 0, F is C bar, 1, 1, F is C. So here the definitions for D0 to D3 are like this, C, C bar, C bar, C, and AB. So you can again still write F of SOP is equal to A bar, B bar, C, A bar, B, C bar, A, B bar, C bar, and A, B, C. So this C is nothing but D0, this C bar is nothing but D1, this C bar is nothing but D2, and this C is nothing but D3. So here you have used a small multiplexer for the implementation of the same function. Instead of 8:1, we have implemented this function using 4:1 mux with some extra hardware, in this case one inverter. You can use these textbooks for your further readings and to solve some more problems based on this content. Thank you.